Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Kim Weisskopf's strange saga of apartment living. There's a man in 211. Starring Lyle Waggoner. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company, Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, Shenley Industries, Matu Swine, and Kodak. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Something indelible about the first of anything. We always remember the first kiss, the first love, the first home together. Rob and Vicki Lewis are young newlyweds with their future ahead of them and a new modern one-bedroom apartment as their first home. It's so new, in fact, that they are the first to move into the building. Or are they? What they don't know yet is there's a man in 211.
As managers of the apartment building, you'll naturally have some responsibilities to the tenants once they start moving in.
Mr. Natov, you'll want to screen all applicants, right?
That's right, my boy. You can't be too careful in who you rent to these days. I spell out every detail in the lease. No children or pets. It's all there in black and white.
Rob, honey, come look.
Oh, excuse me.
Surely.
Isn't this the cutest kitchen you've ever seen? The whole apartment, it's perfect. Oh, we're going to be so happy here.
I just hope we can afford to stay.
Hey, of course we can. We're both working.
Vicky.
Rob.
Oh, wait a minute. The owner's still here.
I really must be going, so perhaps we can finish up. Mrs. Lewis, you like it?
Oh, I love it.
Well, no reason you shouldn't. I wish I'd had something like this when I first got married.
We'll be the best managers you've ever had.
I'm sure you will, dear. You know, this is a thrill for me, helping young married people like you get off to a good start. Pretty soon the whole block will be filled with nice young couples. You should have seen it here before my company bought up the property. Nothing but shacks. Well, you've got everything but the keys. This is the master key. Mm-hmm. There are two sets for each unit, so that's 25 in all.
Okay.
Mr. Lewis, I have your number at work. You know how to reach me. One of you will be here every day between 9 and 6, right?
Hmm?
That's right, yes.
Good. You'll be getting your phone when?
Tomorrow, they said.
That's fine. Well, enjoy.
Goodbye, Mr. Natov. Well,
goodbye. Vicky. Vicky, he's gone.
Rob, what did you tell him?
Well, I said you were the fairy princess and I used to be a frog.
No. I mean about working. Doesn't he know I'm a school teacher?
A substitute teacher.
Yeah, but I won't be here every day. I'm not going to stop teaching.
Well, we'll work something out. I'll talk to Mr. Hansen in the morning. Without me, he's got no one to manage his restaurant. Oh, baby, don't look so glum. Once I'm accepted to law school, we won't have to worry about the future.
Oh, I don't know if I married you because I love you or if I just fell for your Prince Charming routine.
Ribbit, 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 ribbit. Do you mean it?
Of course not. Damn that man. I'd like to pour hot coffee right in his lap.
What's the matter, Marie? You got a picky customer?
Mr. Lewis, if this piece of meat was any rarer, I'd have to lead it in on a rope.
Yeah, it's been that kind of a day. Well, you go have Cookie fry up another one. We'll be off soon.
You look about as tired as I feel. Don't you ever go home?
Have you been talking to my wife?
I don't need to. I'm a woman.
Well, get in the kitchen, woman.
Oh, ain't you the wife?
Good evening, Hansons.
Yes?
Vicky?
Honey, why are you still there?
Oh, Hanson's late as usual. I can't leave. We're really packed. Now, you understand, don't you?
Go ahead and eat without you, then.
Well, I'm sorry, honey. Vicky? Vicky? Yeah, let's see. Bills. Ah, here it is. Yeah, let's see. Dear Mr. Lewis, because of the overwhelming number of qualified applicants who have sent transcripts to our graduate law department, we are unable to consider your application at this time. What? Mother, what's the idea of hanging up on me?
I didn't hang up. We were cut off.
Oh, come on.
I called back and you were gone.
Well, I don't know whether to hug you or slug you. Come here, baby. Oh, Hanson walked in right after we talked. I'm going on nights starting Monday.
Oh, honey. Nights? Well, then we'll never see each other.
What can I do?
Oh, we've been married over a month and we're strangers in our own home.
I know. Well, at least you'll be able to get out during the days. I'm sure the blackboard erasers need cleaning.
You're more important than my going back to work.
We'll stay home together. Great. We can read menus to each other all day long.
Oh, not another one.
Yeah. That's four rejections, two to go. Looks like the only way I'll get into court is to be arrested.
Oh, honey, don't be down. Our first tenants moved in today.
Really? Well, who are they? What are they like?
Well, it's Mr. and Mrs. Myers. They're a little older than I thought they'd be.
How old are they?
In their 60s. He's retired.
60s? Well, what about Natov's speech about nice young couples?
How many young couples can afford this rent?
Well, one less than Natov thinks.
Rob, are you awake?
Huh?
Listen, someone's walking around the upstairs apartment.
Well, maybe our tenants have insomnia.
Honey.
What?
The Myers are in apartment 106 down the hall. There's somebody else upstairs.
Yes?
Good morning, Mr. Myers. I'm Rob Lewis, the manager.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I met your pretty wife yesterday. Everything's fine, just fine. Come in and meet the missus.
Oh, I can't just now. I'm on my way to work.
Well, after work, then. You and your wife stop by for a cup of tea. Louise and I always have tea before bed. My name's John, by the way.
Isn't tea a stimulant? Doesn't it keep you awake night?
Oh, nonsense. Say, after 9 o'clock, the atom bomb couldn't get me up.
Hmm. Well, what about your wife?
Son, we've been married going on the year 40. Now, don't you think I'd know my wife's sleeping habits by this time?
Yes, I guess so.
You guess.
So neither of you were up around 3 this morning?
No, sir. No way.
Leave the dishes, Vicky. I'll get them later.
Oh, catch me, Prince. I'm going to faint.
Come on, we're going up.
What? Oh, wait, I'll get a sweater.
No, you won't need it. We're only going down the hall. We've been invited to tea.
Oh, so you're a school teacher. Well, that's wonderful. Do you take sugar or lemon?
Sugar, please. 2 lumps.
And so is the market slumping like it is, right? Maybe we'll have to move to a cheaper place. We don't want to, though. As soon as a few more folks move into this building, why, it won't be so lonely. It's too bad we
Here's
can't...
your tea, John. Mr. Lewis?
Thank you.
I was just saying that to Rob, it's too bad we're not allowed to have pets here, at least till more people move in.
Well, somebody's breaking the rules around here.
Mrs. Myers?
I distinctly saw a big, long-haired black cat prowling around outside this afternoon. Well,
it must have been a neighborhood cat.
No, I found him up the stairs. Although I must admit he was much faster than I.
What cat? I didn't see any cat.
John, you were napping.
I was?
Where did the cat go, Mrs. Myers?
Well, he walked very deliberately to the last apartment on the end and went inside.
How did he get in?
The door was open. He walked in.
Honey, she's an old lady. Her mind was playing tricks on her.
Like we imagined we heard footsteps up here last night?
Rob, I was home all day. I would have heard if there was anyone here, and I didn't.
That's funny.
What is it?
This end table. I could swear it was at that end of the couch last night.
Well, it was dark, wasn't it?
Well, it's dark now, too. All the windows are locked. Maybe I did leave the door open.
Honey, let's go.
I want to look in the kitchen.
All right.
Here, kitty, 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 kitty.
Oh, now you're being silly.
Yeah, I guess I am. Well, maybe I'm working too hard. Well, let's... Whoop. Okay. What do you say now?
What is it?
Well, take a look. That's as real as we are, honey. I just kicked over a saucer of milk.
No answer?
Yeah, it's busy. You want me to stay home today?
Well, do you want to? I'm so confused.
Well, there has to be some reasonable explanation for this. Now, we've got two keys to that apartment. What is it, 211?
Mm-hmm.
Natov's got one. Now, I don't know. This whole setup is weird. Those tenants, this place, everything.
Well, what'll we do?
Well, I'm going into work. I'll try to reach Natov from there. Now, you call me if anything strange goes on around here, okay?
Okay.
Now, you promise?
Promise.
All right, well, I'd better run. Goodbye, baby.
Bye. Have a good day. Hi, Mr. Rosenberg.
Hello, Vicky. Come in.
Mr. Rosenberg, I wish you'd make up your mind. First, you tell me you do want my husband to know about you, and you disappear. Then you deliberately allow Mrs. Myers to see Rudy, so she'll tell Rob, and you set out a saucer of milk. I don't understand.
But you do trust me.
Well, you've been practically my only company since we moved in. I like you, Mr. Rosenberg, but I don't know that I trust you.
I've kept my word. I told you that you'd have tenants. I even told you what their names would be and how old they were.
Yes, you did, but...
And... I promise you, Vicky, what I said about your husband will happen, too. He will be accepted to law school, mark my word. But you must go along with me just a little longer.
Why not go directly to Mr. Natov? He's the one you want to see.
Mr. Natov is a very tricky fellow. You must know that by now.
Well, he is a little hard to reach.
And I must see him. But it must be done this way. You'll see why later.
Mr. Rosenberg, I don't know how much longer I can go on lying to my husband.
Please, bear with me one more day, just one day. My newspaper has to come today.
Good afternoon, Hanson.
Rob Lewis, please.
Mr. Lewis is gone for the day.
He is? Would you know where he went? This is his wife.
Well, honey, he said if he called to tell you he was going to see the man.
What man did he say?
You know, something he told me, but I can't remember.
Was it Natov, Mr. Natov?
Well, that's it. That's the man he said.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Irresponsible young people.
Yes? Oh, Mr. Natov.
Hey, Mrs. Lewis, I'd like to have a word with you.
Where's Rob?
I have no idea.
What?
I spoke to your husband on the telephone. He told me people have been moving in, an old couple, Myers.
You sound surprised.
I sent no one by that name to this apartment building.
You didn't?
Absolutely not. Our agreement was that I would screen all tenants.
Oh, but I thought they said...
Where are they?
Oh, apartment 106, but they went out an hour ago.
No, what's that? Who's upstairs?
Didn't Rob tell you? Where is my husband?
But tell me what?
There's a man in 211. Rob?
Vicky?
In here, honey. I've got a surprise for you.
Boy, am I really steamed. I finally got Natov on the phone, arranged to meet him downtown, and he didn't show. I stuck my neck out, walked off the job, and he didn't show.
Rob, honey, look.
What's that?
It came today. It's from the university. You've been accepted to the law school.
Hey, that's great. Oh, Vicky. What's that?
Honey, stay here.
Now, don't tell me you don't hear
that. Rob, don't go up there.
You stay here.
No, don't. It's none of our business. It's Mr. Natov.
Oh, good. I want to give him a piece of my mind.
Come back. Don't break the door down. Use the key.
What on earth? There's nothing here.
What happened to the furniture?
Well, where's all that commotion, that scream? Where's Natov? I'm calling the police.
Why?
Why? Because some strange things are going on around here. What's the matter with you, Vicky? You can see, you heard. Noises in the night, phantom cats, oddball tenants, disappearing furniture. What is this? A conspiracy to drive me crazy? If it is, it's working. If you know something I don't, well, tell me.
There was a man here.
What man? Why didn't you tell me before this?
I couldn't. Mr. Rosenberg, well, that's his name, he could see into the future.
Uh-huh. Well, maybe you ought to lie down.
It's true. Where are you going?
Back downstairs. I'm calling a cop and a doctor.
What are you going to tell the police? We don't know what happened.
Well, you tell them what you know about Mr. Rosenberg. I can't make sense out of anything. Especially this newspaper that was sitting outside of Meyer's apartment. Who knows what happened to them?
Hey, isn't that a picture of Mr. Natoff? And that's Mr. Rosenberg. Financier and squatter killed in shootout.
Hmm?
Prominent land developer Leonard Natoff, 46, was shot to death today by a man who refused to leave his condemned house.
What?
Ben Rosenberg, 64, dropped Natoff with one shot, then turned his .22 caliber rifle on himself. Both men were pronounced dead at the scene.
Let me see. His judge under fire as U.S. moves for retrial. Alger Hiss? Where did this paper come from?
It was delivered today. Mr. Rosenberg.
You say you saw this Mr. Rosenberg?
Yes, many times.
And he could see into the future?
Yes, he knew about the Myers coming and your letter of acceptance.
Honey, I believe you, but this newspaper. Look at the date. Saturday, July 9, 1949.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes, exercise your imagination, and join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
As a Man in 211 is an original radio drama by Kim Weisskopf. Lyle Waggoner was heard as Bob Lewis. Featured in the cast were Jane Webb, Frank Nelson, Jay Johnston, Bill Keen, and Diana Hale. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman.